bidding to match Samir by winning a third tournament title this season. So here are the new IRB World Series champions. Samoa with Michael Pessimino back and fit. I was just watching them training just now. The key figures, well, for me, Alapoti Faosaliva has been a massive influence. Uali Mai, the captain, Lola Lui. And here are the young men who have really come up to feed off the top table, with the captaincy superb of James Stannard, his vision, his rugby sevens brain, the midfield, the playmaking of Kararia Henry, and perhaps most influential in this final rounds of Henry van der Glass. So Samoa, I just wonder, are they going to be out on their feet? I watched them just gently warming up out on the back pitch just now after that semi-final against England that lasted 27 minutes 40 seconds. Has it ever been the same before? No, there's never been a second period of extra time. Their 19th final, they've won 6-3 in a row, Las Vegas, Adelaide, Hong Kong. And for Australia, their 10th Cup final, they've won 5, including London last weekend, their first triumph since 2002. It's been a long wait, but now the chance to win back-to-back tournaments since the Shanghai and Malaysia events in 2002. Well, a very good new referee on the circuit is Stuart Berry. He's a good golfer too, by the way. Comes from Durban, he's South African, of course. And he went around one of your courses in 73 shots the other day, Scott. So he's a master of more than one sport.
Sam Torrance's course up at the Fairmont St Andrews, one of the qualifying courses for this year's St Andrews Open. But enough of the golf, back to the rugby and the action in this cup final of the Emirates Airlines Sevens.
Well, it's all about the impact of Australia's young man with van der Glass offloading to Jacob Taylor in the opening seconds. The question, of course, Scott, is how can or can it even be possible for Samoa to pick up having played out that epic semi-final?
Yeah, I just look at this Australian team and they're wanting the back-to-back titles, and it's just that they have the edge coming in, the psychological edge, because job done for Samoa. However, the pride of this particular team and the nation is behind them at this moment in time. It would be fitting, but van der Glass is showing the courage of the Australians to put Taylor in, and that's a mighty blow so early on in this tie.
That hasn't gone the 10 metres, so it'll be a possession for Samoa. And I'm going to put in a plea right at the start here to all of you listening in Samoa. The Prime Minister of Samoa is also the chairman of the Samoan Rugby Union. So good evening to Ilaipa. I think your team, the new champions, deserve a national holiday.
Well done, Nigel.
Well, here they come now. Can they gird their loins? They've lost the tackle first. Released in the tackle first. So
just tackle at 9, release.
Here is a chance for Samoa to get into this game. And, of course, to make it worse, Scott, it's 10 minutes each way for the Samoans. Not that Australia had an easy semi either.
No,
this is Uali Mai. Almost through.
That's good play.
And then in goes Fao Saliva.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting, as you said, Nigel, in terms of how do you get your team up for this one. But you've just got to take it minute by minute and try and get through it. And they'll look to each other for their own strength. And they'll look to each other to continue the skills. But they're up against a very, very good Australian team. This guy, James Stannard, is a wonderful footballer.
And how he has been the mainstay, really, in tactical awareness and leadership. He's the captain of the side. The former captain of Samoa, alongside him, Uali Mai, one of the all-time greats, for sure. 67th tournament, Uali Mai. And the youngster by comparison is James Stannard in only his 8th. And it's Uali Mai playing the sweeper. Reaches levels of fitness one would not have expected after having a bit of time off. And here now, Rupeni Lavasa. Played a key part in that epic semi-final. How well England played too. They lifted their game.
6, release.
Well, as they have done so often, to make it just an absolute classic.
You're interfering both your feet.
So the honour for Stuart Berry.
6 interferes in the ruck.
As the man to be in charge of the final. Uali Mai on now with Simaika Mikaeli. Glad to see that Pessimino is fit to start. There was some question mark as he pulled up after his long try. Here he comes now, Has he got another of those magical runs that have glittered this season? 53 tries he scored in one season, only exceeded by De La Sau in the in a series when they had far more tournaments than now. I think there were 13 tournaments in that season when he got 80. But Pessimino, they need him.
Yeah, absolutely. If he'd taken that ball, he was perhaps in for his next one. But Lola Louis just trying to ensure that he just settles down.
There's the captain, Lola Louis. Referee just dwelling a little because the ball's away. And no one's hurrying. I think the Ilzes might be a little bit jaded too after their epic and their first win for 8 years over New Zealand in the semi-final. There's Pessimino, look at that. And how well too those behind him have played this season. Kurt Baker, second in line. So these friendly but powerful men from Samoa against the sprightly youngsters, the guys who've just learned so fast. And bear in mind, half a dozen who played most of the season for Australia are now out at the Junior Rugby World Championship in Argentina. And these guys have stepped up from being reserves in the squad to fronting up, winning in London last week. But now they face a challenge. Have Samoa come again, Lola Louis. And they try to spread it wide. Fau Saliva, who likes to take out two defenders, in goes Ed Jenkins.
You missed it.
Once more with Mikaeli. Now, Uali Mai, the creator. This is Lavassa. Lavassa through. He's superbly strong, direct in his approach, and a wonderful finisher that brings Samoa right back into the tussle.
Rupina Lavassa, he's the first one to strike. And this is what I was saying about Samoa, never see die attitude. It's the inner strength they can derive from each other. Kelly with the long pass. Uelimai, he's always everywhere. And he just showed the ball. And on the wraparound, sold the dummy to Jacob Taylor.
The young man, just 24, from the Vailele Club in Apia, the capital of Samoa. And all these players, just so you get no wrong idea, all of them play in and are based in Samoa. And it's a move that the Samoan Rugby Union made, and lucky with the conversion off the upright just a short time ago, and my word, it's paid dividends as they have come through this season and are bidding now for their fourth title in their overall championship winning season. But Australia have the edge, 2 points, and the keenness, look on the face there of Ed Jenkins. The knock back to Ali Mai, pirouettes out of the tackle to the hands of Lola Louis, the quiet leader, and the power of Pessimino. Oh, a little error advantage, it came off Iono, one of the unsung heroes here, captain just 2 years ago of the Samoan under 20 side in Wales.
Yeah, well, Fau Saliva taken well by Jacob Taylor. And that's the one thing about the Samoans, if you can bring them to the deck, they can't get that continuity into the game. I've seen so many tries scored with them standing big in the tackle and somebody coming on the inside arc.
Shoots out, awkward one for Stannard. And the ball is won back cleverly by Samoa through the legs of Lola Louis, switched by Uali Mai. See who's standing out on the right-hand edge here. It's Mikaeli Pessimino. I'm sure he's got a run or two left in him. He was looking easy and comfortable out on the warm-up pitch. Drop goal attempt, Lola Louis. We saw what he did in the semi-final to clinch it in extra time. He's done that before too, in Wellington, I recall, to win a game. But that was off target, it'll be a 22. But was that a sign of tiredness?
Oh, absolutely a sign of tiredness, and quite a sensible option actually, you know, just to maybe nudge Samoa into a one-point lead. But they've still got them pinned down, Nigel, in the 22, and Australia are going to have to attack from deep.
Up goes Van der Glass, didn't get the little tap back into his own hands. Advantage then from a knock-on advantage over. This is Iono, Afa Iono. And they're working sweetly here, Samoa, under a lot of pressure and trying to put the semi-final thoughts behind them. On drives Mikaeli, two men wide, must be a score in the corner, or cutting back inside. And guess who? Uali Mai, 19th try of the season. and that adds on to his remarkable record of over 120. It's 132 now. Fine, thank you.
But what about that pass from Mikaeli just over the top? Eluded Henry van der Glass. Well, he's breathing deeply, Olimai, but he makes him tick. Lolalui came across. The shrug off by Mikaeli. The pop pass. And Olimai back on the angle, skips inside both van der Glass and Jacob Taylor.
Well, his first tournament was Hong Kong 2000. Now this married man with a young family is causing the celebrations in the stand. It's early days. Remember, 10 minutes each way is an eternity. But Samoa lead 12-7 with a minute and a little bit to go of this first half. Wally Mai, the restart expert, didn't go 10.
I think you played it first, that's why 10.
And it was because Bessamino may have got hands on first. It wasn't Bessamino because he wasn't there. They do have, of course, the important situation of allowing three substitutes off the bench. Meanwhile, van der Glass goes on the break. Big tackle that made him throw forward. That was Lolalui. I'm sure Samoa will be trying to conserve their replacements till the game moves into the second half.
Yeah, as you mentioned earlier on, it's how the co-op Lolalui hands onto the coattails of van der Glass, and he's still got the effort to put in a hard tackle and dislodge the ball from van der Glass. But you just take each minute as it comes, as I mentioned, and the fact is that Samoa will look to each other for their inner strength. It's been quite outstanding.
Taken back.
I think the extraordinary thing about this Australian lineup, I've mentioned the absentees who've been there most of the season, but only three of the players, this is one of them, James Stannard, have actually played last season in the Aussie lineup. It was extraordinary work put together by Michael O'Connor, and what a reward he's received. Good work from Ed Jenkins there. But no one's there except for Mikaeli Pessamino. Stannard chases, Pessamino wins. Alert, and for once Australia just didn't keep the eye literally on the ball, which came out free for Pessamino to grasp and streak away.
Well, the understanding, Pessamino, he just hit the beeline for the corner, beats Stannard, tops it off with a try, and they're just taking their chances, their reading of the situation, their understanding together is what's taking them ahead of Australia.
Well, is that to be a winning dive? I was chatting with Stephen Beetham just before the teams came to the dressing rooms for the final, and he said, well, we're going to rely on our euphoria of winning the title to dispense with the long, tired legs that they have, and it's shown very well in the first half. They look inspired rather than tired.
Oh, it's incredible, the euphoria, the adrenaline they must be living on, but it's just this innate ability to ensure that the will to win, which they've got used to this season.
Well, it's half-time, and here is Stephen Beetham now, and remarkably, what a season. He must be so thrilled because he only took over the coaching role this season from Rudy Moores. Play for him, they play for Lolalui, they play for their country folk where rugby is king. And Michael O'Connor, don't count this one out yet. Australia, 5 cup wins in 10 finals. And remember, until last week, there'd been an 8-year gap. They then beat New Zealand in the semi today. That was their first win since that cup winning run in Brisbane all those years ago. So we have 10 minutes to play out, and the lead for Samoa of 10 points.
Well, it's come down to this, Nigel. We've witnessed some fantastic sevens here at Murrayfield today, and is there more to come? Is there a sting in the tail? Can Samoa continue this absolute brilliance that they've dominated throughout this season with their exuberance, their fantastic individual skill, and their passion for the game of sevens.
You put it absolutely on the nail there, Scott. That's exactly those elements that combine to produce this championship side. They'd love to round it off the best possible way, of course, with a title at the end to add to those earlier three. Australia, they'd love that double head-to-head, back-to-back, and they may yet get it. Jacob Taylor, and they're fit and young, and Ed Jenkins, another Sydney University lad. And there's Van der Glass to Stannard, now to Nick Phipps, and threat here on the wide outside will come from Ed Stubbs. It's checked for a moment, but not altogether. Look at the drive of the man.
And away, tackler.
Still within 2 metres, and still Aussie ball. Kararia Henry, James Stannard, sees a gap. It closes.
Yes.
Wonder if that was the right option for him then, but he's got a penalty out of it. So there's a penalty over here.
Roll away.
Says Stuart Berry, got to roll away after the tackle. So the pressure on. And remember, it's only 10 points and it's a long, long half. Van der Glass fears nobody.
Two roll.
Takes out a couple of defenders. 3-1 on the left, on the right, I mean, Stannard. He sees the gap. Did he ground it straight away? He's grounded it now. Anyway, this 27-year-old from Queen Bean and New South Wales and keeps this game on the knife edge.
Yeah, if you're going to put money on an Australian player to score a try to get Australia back into this tie, it's James Stannard. Just good awareness by putting some more under pressure in the tackle area. When you're that close to the line and you put a step in, you can sometimes worry your opponent, turning them, and Stannard found the space.
And the conversion attempt by the try scorer to get within 3 points. That'll do. Cool customer, isn't he?
Yes, it was Henry Van der Glass. He's been great today for Australia as well. And just the movement going there, and it was Iona fell off his man, Fal Saliva, with a desperate tackle. Iona was just set wide, which allowed the space for Stannard to step into.
Well, I rate this as the time of truth, really, for Samoa. Are those legs going to weaken, or have they still got the, I don't know, the depth of fitness, the stamina to survive and stay ahead? Rupeni Lavasa.
No hands.
Away. Via Iono, up the middle, little Luali Mai, then the big drive of Mikaeli.
No hands, no luck.
They come again, it's going to be on the bounce. This is Pessimino, could be a good chance here, he goes, he slips one tackle, he drives to the line, slides and scores. Yet again, Pessimino, he took the gamble. He had the men outside, but he used them as a decoy, and he just had the strength, the momentum took him over. A little salute to celebrate, and yet again, he turns it on like this.
How good is this man at this game of sevens? It's his ability to look at the gap, and it's his long, loping stride. He just tees with the opposition, throws the dummy pass, Kararia Henry. This is the tackle, and despite the despairing efforts of Australia, look at this reach for the line. It means something for Samoa. It means everything for Samoa.
You have it in one. Well, I bet the excitement in Apia and those beautiful islands of Samoa will be riveted if you're watching with us. Well, we're feeling it for you. 24-14. But still, just under 6 minutes to play. If it stays with the Samoan lead and the cup title here in Edinburgh for the first time to add to the championship overall of the IRB World Series, there will be a few drinks taken, I'm sure. Fatu Otto, this could be the key moment because that stretches them away by 15 points. And have Australia suddenly begun to creak? The wheels haven't come off, by all means they won't, but they're looking a little vulnerable for the first time in this tournament.
Yeah, very much so, all down to the possession and the wonderful kickoff. And Otto, well, he was sharp, but Ulemai, well, he takes that lob wedge out again. Back comes the ball, he's sharper than anybody. And when he took that ball, the Australians just suddenly, for that millisecond, looked at each other in disbelief to see that's a seven-pointer, we've lost this. Henry Van der Glas in particular just looked to the heavens.
Well, and an important conversion, it's a 17-point lead. I guess most of us were thinking, well, Samoa, you know, will they pick up after a brief interval, really? Just had the other three finals since their semi. And the other, of course, the other semi-final. But they've suddenly found a depth, a stamina, and as you say, they've left that concern behind them. And they are now three scores clear of Australia. They've met them 35 times up till today. Samoa have won 17, Australia 16. But never in a cup final have they met. Here's Ayono. One more and that will kill off Australia, these brave young Wallabies for sure. And they come again with Trevor Annis on the field. He's played a big part in the season. Pessimino still out there. I thought he might have had a little pull of a muscle in that semi, but he's rested then, and how well that's paid off. Here he goes again, but pulls the defence across by going up the short side. And knock on will give another breathing space for Samoa.
What's interesting is that Samoa are deriving pleasure from this game. Number 7. Because when you're commanding possession, it's an easier game. When you're trying to chase the game, that's what makes it difficult. But because Samoa have got the possession, they're the ones in control. So the game is an awful lot easier. Michael O'Connor looks on. What can his Australian team turn around? But really, is this Samoa's moment of glory?
Well, they've had a wonderful two weekends. They won in London, beating Fiji, Argentina, South Africa in the knockout rounds. England too on the first day. Here they've beaten, they were drawn with England, won Fiji, won against New Zealand. And this, you fell over, says referee Berry to Pessimino. Just 3 minutes remain, 17 points the difference. Australia will fight to the last gasp. Did an Australian sporting team ever do anything else like New Zealand? There's no white flags going to come up here. 2 minutes, 50 seconds, and all the time, the hold-up of the ball, the clock counts down Samoa's favour.
Well, Clinton Sills from the Australian winger flying machine came in to take that ball into the contact, was held up, and Samoa gained the possession because Australia couldn't get that ball onto the deck.
And Samoa have moved up for Alatasi Tupu, fresh legs as a replacement, but Uali Mai is going to be out controlling affairs in the midfield. This is Fa'atua Otto. Now it's Tupou. They can do their bit. Fa'atua Otto offloads to Otto. Otto has got there, and that is klop and klaar, as they say in South Africa. Game, set, and match. Brilliant. What a performance by Samoa. I did not believe they would dominate like this.
Yeah, absolutely, bro. The individual skill, but the recognition of where to put the man into the space. Just the switch play then, and the offload to Ulemai. He then just sets up with the step. Oh, in actual fact, sorry. It was Tupou.
I mean, this is the great thing. That he, you know, Stephen Beetham hasn't taken the gamble because he's got fresh legs, but it's great because their whole squad are taking part in this celebration as Ulemai is off target. But now we're talking about a 22-point lead, and you know, the biggest win ever in the history of Samoa over Australia is 30 points, and to do this in a final after that epic semi is remarkable against a very, very talented Australian team. And whatever the outcome here, rest assured there's a new dimension to the IRB Sevens, because we have Australia at that top table capable of beating anybody. But is Pessimino going to have the last word? Look at the pace of the man. He dives, he scores a hat-trick in the final. Well, no wonder he doesn't smile freely, but he's every cause to have the toast of Samoa tonight. The hat-trick for Pessimino caps his outstanding season as surely the player of the IRB Sevens World Series. Magic, magic.
Yeah, well, Nigel, we've seen some brilliant ties here. Pessimino, it's fitting, isn't it? Because he's not only scored a hat-trick in the final, He's been the player of the series, as you said, all the way through. This is what he's done. He's split defences open, whether it be his chip and chase, whether it be his step and go, and whether it be his skill of beating men one-on-one. He has been an inspiration to his country.
Well, can I come to Samoa and join you all listening in tonight? I think it'll be a lovely place to be for the next week of celebration. And I hope that Prime Minister will heed those remarks, because it's going to be an exceptional double. There goes the final whistle. Samoa, not just the IRB Sevens World Series champions, but the champions of this great Emirates Airline Edinburgh Sevens 2010. That closes a remarkable season. And who is there in this crowd, or who watching on television, who cannot but Samoa, champions of Edinburgh this weekend and champions of the 11th IRB Sevens World Series. There's the man who's put it all together alongside Infabo Nilalomilo, the manager. I'm sure he's close to tears. Lovely warmth of typical South Sea Islanders, and my heartiest congratulations. And to Stuart Berry, who was in charge of that final. Some of the players are on their knees, and they're a very religious people, and they will, well, make the appropriate prayers and thanks to the influences from above. And there, Oali Mai, what a dream that he came back, because he wasn't going to even be in action with the Sevens, because he was intending to go to the Cornish Pirates and they wouldn't let his visa pass. And all I can say is thank goodness for Samoa that he didn't get to play 15s in the Cornish Pirates this season. And there, Pessimino. Scott, tell us all about it.
Yeah, it's just been absolutely superb, a real team effort. I must say, I'm very humbled by what Stephen Beetham said after that brilliant semi-final victory over England. He says, no, we haven't won just the series, we've come here to win another game.
And the words of thanks from these very religious people who hold their national flag. All of you in Apia and all through Samoa would be proud of how proud your rugby representatives in this Sevens game are of their lovely country. So congratulations to all of you. At the same time, to Australia, what can you say? Brilliant in winning the title last week in London, brilliant in getting to the final again a week later with this young side that Michael O'Connor has put together. The courtesies are there, the warmth, which is very special to the game of sevens between these teams who live together, stay together, travel together. And Scott, I know too that you are very appreciative of them too. And to Australia, to James Stannard, the captain, congratulations as well, as he speaks with Johnny Cox on the touchline.
James, congratulations, great tournament, bad luck in the final. It seems like you have a great team spirit in that side.
Yeah, we do, mate. We're a very close-knit team, and, mate, I couldn't ask any more from the last 2 weeks. It's been incredible.
Excellent. It didn't really seem to go your way. What's the next plans for the team moving forward to Delhi?
Well, I guess we've got a tournament next week in Rome, and I think we've just got to look forward and fix up our mistakes, like our set piece and stuff like that, and I think we'll give it a good crack.
Well, congratulations again. Great tournament, great success in London.
Thanks, mate.
Well, a player with a wonderful future, maybe not just in sevens, because so many young Wallabies have gone through to the national 15, but I think Michael O'Connor will do his best to keep some of this young talent together. Meanwhile, the celebrations go on of the happy, happy Samoans. The warmth and their friendliness and their modesty too is something that stands out. But I do think one of the great things about sevens rugby is not just the brilliant sport that we've witnessed today, but the actual spirit of the game, which may have been lost in some respects in 15s, is still there in the sevens games. where, in what other international sport would teams be greeting each other in the corridor, in the dining room where they all are together each week, each tournament, and with the courtesies and the respect that they give to each other. So it'll take a while for it to sink in. To win the championship was their dream, to win the title, well, that was close behind. And we will have the presentations very shortly, but as Pessimino looks on, let's have a word with one of the Samoan squad who played a part in this wonderful season. He's with Johnny Cox. I think it's Pale Toalupe.
Pale Toalupe, fantastic win, fantastic series. How do you feel?
I feel good. We're on top of the world right now, and we just want to thank our families, relatives, and everyone back home for supporting us this whole way through. We've come a long way, and we're happy to be where we are now.
Excellent. And what was the feeling in the camp between the semi-final? What a fantastic game, right down to the wire. What was said between the semi and the final?
We just needed to stick to our basics, keep the ball going wide, and stick to the basics, which we did well in the final. And it turned out to be in our favour. So yeah, it was good.
And you have a last little message for everybody back home?
Yes, I do.
Congratulations again. Wonderful.
Well, the sun shines down this early evening here in Edinburgh, and congratulations. You could see even then the little touch of modesty, no bragging. And now the moment of presentation with the chairman of the International Rugby Board, Bernard Lapasse, there, second along, and alongside him, Richard Vaughan, Divisional Senior Vice President of the Commercial Operations Worldwide of the Edinburgh Airlines, of the Emirates Airlines, the sponsors of this Edinburgh tournament. So a hushed, polite crowd here who have witnessed some great sport. And there is the Vice President from Commercial Operations Worldwide of Emirates, Richard Vaughan. And the last man to receive the medal will be the man who will raise the cup here in Edinburgh for the first time. Lola Louie from Moata'a, one of those few players who's played sevens and 15s in a Rugby World Cup, who's broken his jaw in the cause of Samoa, who has captained them to this great triumph. And here is the moment of triumph. Samoa, Emirates Airline Edinburgh Sevens champions of 2010. And of course, what a double act, because they too, by reaching the final today, ensured that they are also the IRB World Series Sevens champions. Only the fourth in history. New Zealand have won 8 of the titles over the years since 1999. Fiji have won it once, South Africa won it last year. And now a new name on the champion series of this great IRB event. There they are, not boastful at all. And let's have a look at how then the final series stands. Samoa in the end with a 15-point margin over New Zealand, who battled as they always do to the very last and nearly could have pulled it off. Australia, the runners up here in third place, Fiji in fourth, and England in that epic semi-final end up fifth bravely under Ben Ryan, and in fifth place on 96 points. South Africa, last year's winners, in sixth. But who can tell you next season which of all those on that graphic display will be at the top of the table next season? And isn't that, Scott, the beauty of the whole thing?
It is the beauty of the game. And just listening to that last interview from Samoa, it was the moral standing of this game within the community, the families, the passion, the pleasure that they derive from representing their countries.
The happiest of men there, Lola Louie. So as the sun begins to set here in Ulriki, We're here at Murrayfield, where Scotland did themselves proud by winning the plate. Wales won the bowl. Russia won the shield. It's time for us to say a very warm goodbye to you all from Johnny Hammond, from Wyn Griffiths, Scott Hastings, Johnny Cox, the proactive team of Alan Morton, Thomasina Kay, the directors today, Gareth Mainwaring, Steve Cotter, our statistical wizards of the whole season, HD Vision, led by Sean Glover, and the lady who puts this great series together, the IRB Sevens manager, Beth Coulter. So from me, Nigel Starmer-Smith, it's a very good night and goodbye. We'll be back with you in December. But from the beauty of Edinburgh, the triumph of Samoa, goodbye, wherever you are in the world, and hope to see you soon.